control. Starting in the fourth position, Brian Card. Starting third from Fort Myers, Florida, driving an X-Ray with a Speed 6 body, Hobby Wing speed control, and the handout motor is, of course, Orca and Jayco. Starting third is Jarrett Parsons. Starting second from Jackson, Tennessee, driving an X-Ray, Protoform LT6-R, the Orca motor, the speed control is a Speed Passion, and of course, Jayco tires. Showing some help here from Speed Passion, RC America, and Pro Match Racing. Starting second is Matt Lyons. TQ for amateur 17.5 here in the 2015 Snowbird National. He hails from Irmo, South Carolina. Driving an X-Ray with an LTCR Protoform body, the handout motor, and of course a Tekin ESC. Special thanks going out to Brian Busey, John Tag, and the BRR crew. Starting on the point, your TQ, Isaac Morgan.
All right, gentlemen, take a lap, please. Take a lap. Greg's going to come out there and line you guys up. So take a lap.
We got a D and a C coming up. Yeah, they shouldn't have sponsors around. That's what we were just talking about. Yeah. Who is that? That's what we were just talking about, me and Greg. Is he the only one? Wow. I know.
Got all the lower mains.
Huh?
All lower main winners, you guys can pick up your plaques in tech. Once again, all lower main winners, you guys can pick up your plaques in tech. So if you were in the B, the C, the D, and the E, you can pick up your plaques in tech. This is Touring Amateur 17.5, a name. All right, guys, grid is set. Do not move your cars. Grid is set. Do not move your cars, please. Turn marshals are ready. Driver's ready. Next sound you hear will be the start of your Touring Amateur 17.5 A Main in less than 5. And we're off. Isaac Morgan's going to lead in the infield. Matt Lyons looking in the inside early. Isaac Morgan in that red, orange, white car. Matt Lyons in the white and blue. Lyons putting pressure on Morgan early on in this one. Remember, guys, it's a full 5-minute race. Don't go bonsai in there early. Watch straightaway, guys. High on the straight. Clear. Isaac Morgan, your leader. Matt Lyons in second. Jerry Mowry, Brian Carr battling out in the back of the third spot. Washington King, guys. Washington King, clear. Top two making their way through the S section now. Through the chicane they go and down the back straight. That is Morgan and Lyons. Oh, and Lyons taps. It's going to give Morgan a little bit of breathing room. Brian Card now putting pressure on Matt Lyons for that second position. Brian Card in the all orange working their way down the back stretch. Come up on a back marker. They get by. 9-7 last time by for both drivers. They work their way through the chicane and down the back stretch they go. 1, 2, and 3 into the infield. In front of the driver's stand. It's Morgan leading Lyons and Carr with 1:30 down, 3:30 left to go. Isaac Morgan, your leader, 9-7 last time by. Matt Lyons, 9-6. Carr with a 9-8. As they work their way back into the infield once again, they're going to come up on some lap traffic. That's the leader coming into the infield through the sweeper, 2 and 3 right behind them. Lyons now closing that gap between himself and first place of Isaac Morgan. It's down to 5/10 of a second now. Black, white, next cars you see will be the leaders. 2:10 down, 2:50 to go. Isaac Morgan still the man on top. Matt Lyons in that second spot. Brian Card in the three. Then we got Jared Parsons in the four. Jared Mary in the five. Birchfield in the six. Matt Lyons now has that gap down to 4/10 of a second. Last lap for Morgan, 9-7. Lyons, 9-7. Leaders working their way through the chicane and down the backstretch. Morgan, 9-8. Lyons, 10 flat. Oh, and Morgan taps. It's going to let Lyons close the door even more. Lyons all over the back door of Isaac Morgan. As they work their way once again through chicane, Lyons tries to cut it a little bit too close, catches the pipe. Gap now showing at 8/10 of a second. Black and white, that is third place behind you. Thank you, sir. Good job. We got 3:10 down, 1:50 left to go. Matt Lyons once again trying to close that gap between himself and Isaac Morgan. Last lap for Morgan, 9-8. Lyons, 10 flat. Brian Card, 9-9. Top three working their way down the straightaway. That is 1, 2, and 3. Morgan leading the way. That is the dark red, pink, and white car, followed by the white and blue of Matt Lyons, and then the all-orange of Brian Card. Last lap for Morgan, 9-9. Matt Lyons, 9-8. Brian Card, 9-7. Leaders now coming up on us in traffic. They get by.
1 minute left.
You heard the man. What, less than 1 minute to go in this one. Touring Amateur 17-5 brought to you by Orca. Lyons now really pouring it on. Lyons all over. Looks on the inside. Oh, and Lyons and Morgan get into it. Card now up into that second spot. Morgan drops into third. Matt Lyons, your new leader, buying Card in second. Lyons in that top spot, Brian Card in second, Morgan in third. Leader now working his way once again into the infield in front of the driver's stand. Through the S-section he goes. Brian Card now all over the back door of Matt Lyons. Leader white and blue, second place of Brian Card in the all-orange. Card goes a little bit wide in front of the driver's stand. The gap showing at 3/10 of a second with 10 seconds left to go. Body tuck on Morgan. That's time of the clock. This can be the final lap. Race to the line. And Matt Lyons is going to take the win in Touring Amateur 17-5. Brian Carr finishes in second. Jared Parsons in third. Birchfield finishes in fourth. Jared Mary in fifth. Isaac Morgan in sixth. Kyle Lumpel in seventh. Blake Ryan finishes in eighth. Darrell Bingner in ninth. Jose Moreno finishes in tenth. Next, 112 GTP stock, 17.5, D Main.
Rich Grubb. Chris Crowder. Chris Leach.
Hey, Gene.
Starting positions will be Chris Crowder on pole, followed by Rich Grubb and Chris Leach. If one of you guys in the center could grid these guys. Marshall's in the center. Marshall's in the center. If you guys could grid them up for us, that'd be great. It's cool. We got it. Okay. Driver's ready, Marshall's ready. You guys are going at the sound of the tone in less than five. D-Main 112 GTP stock 17.5 is underway. Lonesome. Rich Grubb some 4 seconds back. Chris Leach an additional six.
Thank you, sir.
One minute down here. Seven to go. Chris Crowder, his pace 48 and 8 flat last time through, and 9-8, only car in the nine so far. Then it's Rich Grubb and Chris Leach. 10-2 for Grubb, 10-3 for Leach. On 3 minutes down here with five to go.
Do you guys always have a problem?
Crowder in that lead spot, followed by Grubb and Leach. Caution coming off the sweeper. Fastest car on track, 10-2. Grubb with a 13, Leach with a 10-4.
Oh, they were? almost past the halfway mark here. Crowder's pace edging up ever so slightly. He's now on a 49 in 8.05. Decent race for second here. Leach and Grubb separated by 2.7 seconds. Leach, that blue car, and Grubb, that orange car. Great Massacre?
You didn't see anything? It's just open up there?
No, I was here for VTA.
You were here?
What do you mean by Great Massacre? Depends on how you think about it. Hanulik and, what's-his-face? Mark Burke. They had a great race, and Burke kept waiting up for him, repassing him, and he'd dump him, and he'd wait for him and pass him again. Hanulik ended up third, Burke won, and Michael Bruce got second.
Five down, three to go. Crowder going 9-8, dipping back into the nines again. He's had a bunch of them, strung them all together here. It's why he's leading and why his pace is getting up there. Leach getting a little bit of extra time out on his gap back to Grubb in that third spot. So it's Crowder, Leach, and Grubb. Last time through 9-9 for Crowder, backs it up with a 9-6. Leach goes 11-2 and Grubb 11-6. Up next, C Main, 1/12 scale, GTP stock. Wonder what that noise is. Six down, two to go. Out on the back straightaway. That silver and orange car now cruising through his infield.
Fair enough, fart. I won't fart anymore. Too late.
Thank you, sir. I'll put him in there. Nah, don't worry about it. Because I got to put him in upside down order. Thank you, though. 1 minute.
1 minute left.
What's up, boss?
You've got a guy from the C all the way up in the A on the sheets over there.
That's odd.
Just check it, you know.
Okay. Do you don't remember his name?
Ed Sheeran.
30 seconds.
Ed Sheeran?
Yeah, you had him on the A main.
How'd that happen?
You had Jared in the B main.
Okay. And Jarrett was in the B, so he was in the A. That's weird.
Yeah, 10 seconds left to go.
That's a C main coming up next. This is the D. C's coming up next. They're not ready yet.
There's time. Race it to the line, everybody. Race it to the line. They already went that way. Everybody's done. Here it is. Chris Crowder taking it down, 49 and 8.07. Staying real consistent all the way through, followed by Leach and Grubb. C-Main, 1/12 GTP stock, coming to the stand. GTP stock 17.5 brought to us by DiscountRCStore.com.
Steve Laliberte, Jim McGee, William Crotty, Ralph Morella, Joey Krasinski.
Chris Crowder picks up the win in the D main for 12th scale stock. It's early morning, but pretty good run out there, Chris. Not a lot of traffic.
No, there's only three in the race, but that's what happens when you don't finish a qualifier, I guess. But not being able to run on carpet very much is going to change now. We're opening up 386 Raceway here in Daytona, so be able to get more carpet practice in.
That sounds good. A lot of the Florida guys, we run outside a lot, don't run a carpet very often, so that's great news to hear that track coming on long line here probably just a couple weeks.
Yeah, we're our opening weekend is Valentine's weekend, so.
Gotta love it.
Oh, yeah. Ready for it. Thank you very much.
Sounds good. Great race, Chris. Good to see you again.
Okay, we need volunteer marshals. Volunteer marshals, anybody chilling on the sidelines, if you could spare 8 minutes of time, we would greatly appreciate it. We cannot run this race without volunteer marshals. Just not enough people. Anybody hanging out, just kicking around, who want to come out and volunteer marshal? You got it, boss. First person volunteer gets the closest corner to them. Anybody else? Volunteer marshals, please, please, please. If anybody can spare 8 minutes of your time, we need this guy's going to marshal right here. The one in the corner. Oh, look at this. Nice. Anybody else? Volunteer marshal. Anybody? Bueller? You are the man. You are microman. Yes, you are. Sam will point you in the right direction. Hey, Sam, I got another one right here. I got some fresh meat. Sam, where do you want the guy in the red? Anytime. You want micro? All right, guys, did your warm-up laps. I just need Patrick St. Germain and Peter Pitar to check in. Patrick and Pitar, I need you guys to check in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We're missing one. Patrick and Pitar. I need you guys to check in. Go across the line. No? How do I have 9 cars and 10 drivers? No, that's Patrick. What about Pitar? Could be. Yeah, right? All right, guys. Let's go line them up. Patrick's going to be in that first spot. Sir, could you give us a grid?
Patrick Germain.
Ralph Morello in the second spot. Steve Laliberti in the third spot. Pitar would be in fourth if he's on the driver's stand. So it goes Patrick, Ralph, Steve, Pitar, William, Joey, Brandon,
Peter Ed.
Jim, Brian, and Joe.
Wait, are you even putting him in order for me?
Yeah.
I love you.
There you go. I want to thank the volunteer marshals once again. We really appreciate it.
Thank you, too.
This is C-Main 112 GTP Stock 17.5 brought to us by DiscountRCStore.com. Thank you, Sam. Driver's ready, marshal's ready. Nope. What do we got going on here? Driver's ready, marshal's ready. You guys are going with the sound of the tone in less than five. A little bit of static down the end of the sweeper. We're not even getting through the infield very well here. Bad things happening everywhere. Up front, Patrick St. Germain, Ralph Morella, and Steve Laliberti checking out. Top three freight train out of the back straightaway. Through the sweeper they go. Everybody's trying passes. Leader gets caught up in the board all by himself. Top three will shuffle as they come across the line. Let's see what happens. It's Steve, Ralph, Patrick, Brandon, William, Joe, Joey, Pitar, Jim, and Brian. They shuffle again coming across the line. Bunch of cars down in the 9-1s, including your leader, Steve Laliberti, who until Pitar put in an 8-9, had fast lap in this race. bunch of cars down in the 9-1s, including your leader, Steve Laliberti, who, until Pitar put in an 8-9, had fast laps.
Top four, within 1.5 seconds of one another.
Bunch of cars down in the 9-1s.
And they're basically all white cars. Fantastic. Oh,
top.
I believe that was your leader, one of the many white cars.
And they're basically all white cars. Fantastic.
Steve Laliberti in that top spot, followed by Patrick Saint-Germain, Brandon Skews, Ralph Morella, Pitar, and Joe Conti, Joey Krasinski, William Crotty, Brian Busey. We run up under the skirt. The man's got skills.
Steve Laliberti in that top spot, followed by Patrick Saint-Germain,
extracting cars from the skirt.
Pitar, and Joe Conti, Joey Krasinski, William Crotty, Brian Busey. We run up under the skirt. The man's got skills.
1:45 down, 6:15 to go.
Extracting cars from the skirt.
Brian Busey, we run up under the skirt.
1:45 down, 6:15 to go.
Extracting cars from the skirt.
Drew Ellis to Mike Boylan. Drew Ellis, please come to the principal's office. 2:30 down, 5:30 to go. Steve Laliberti last time through 9.5. Patrick Saint-Germain, 2 seconds back, but running 1/10 of a second faster every lap. He's got 5 minutes and 15 seconds to reel him in. To go. It's Laliberti, Saint-Germain, Morella, Skews, Krasinski, Crotty, N, Busey, Conti, and McGee out early. Up next, 112 stock 17.5 GTP. Stay high going to the sweeper, high going to the sweeper, stay high going to the sweeper, all clear.
Up next, 112 stock 17.5 GTP. Stay high going in the sweeper, high going in the sweeper, stay high going in the sweeper, all clear.
Up next, 112 stock, 17.5 GTP.
We're all heck breaking loose over here in the chicane. All clear. Gene. Coming up on the halfway mark, drivers.
All heck breaking loose over here in the chicane. All clear.
Gene.
Coming up on the halfway mark, drivers.
This is nine-ish.
All clear.
Got Matt's trophy.
Oh, thank you for picking that up. Appreciate it. I couldn't find you guys. I didn't know where you were.
Yeah, I didn't
halfway mark, drivers.
Yep. Well, everybody forgets about him over at there and just walks away.
4:20 down, 3:40 to go. It's Laliberti, Morella, Skews, Krasinski, Saint-Germain, Crotty, Busey, Conti, and N. Good battle for third between Skews and Krasinski. Krasinski just 0.3 seconds back. Morella gets turned hard coming out of the straightaway, showing good courtesy there. Another driver let him get going again.
Find out more at FermanCJDTampa.com.
Ralph Marlin in that second spot, 3.2 seconds back from your leader, Steve Laliberti.
Get going again.
That white car heading towards the driver's stand right now with the black rims.
Ralph Marlin in that second spot, 3.2 seconds back
from your leader. Last time through, Laliberti 9.5, Morella 9.8, Saint-Germain 9.9.
Towards the driver's stand right now with the black rims.
Crotty 9.8, Skews 9.6, Krasinski 9.5, Busey 10 flat, Conti 10.7.
Morella 9.8, Saint-Germain 9.9. Crotty 9.8, Skews 9.6, Krasinski 9.5, Busey 10 flat, Conti 10.7.
Morella 9.8, Saint Germain 9.9. Crotty 9.8, Skews 9.6, Krasinski 9.5, Busey 10 flat, Conti 10.7.
Six down, two to go. This is the ninth race, labeled 16. Sorry for the confusion. Up next, race 17, the 10th one today. 112th GTP stock, 17.5A main.
The ninth race, labeled 16.
These are the fastest of the slow cars here in 12 scale.
Race 17, the 10th one today. 112th GTP stock, 17.5A main. These are the fastest of the slow cars here in 12 scale.
1:30 left to go.
112th GTP stock, 17.5A main.
Ralph Morella, wheeled your leader in. Your leader had one or two slow laps, and that's all it took. Good battle here. Going through to chicane it out onto the back straightaway.
Ralph Morella.
That's the top two with a minute 15 left to go. And your leader taps. Ralph Morella slides into that top spot. Let's see if he can hang on to it for a minute left. Last time through, 9-4 for Morella and Little Birdie. Actually, Little Birdie goes 10-7 with that tap. He's got the pace, though. He could be right there. Morella and Little Birdie. Skirting certain death coming out of the back straightaway, squeezing between two lap cars that were checked up in an accident during the chicane. Little Birdie tabs last time through, Morella 9-6, Little Birdie 10-1. Uh-oh, they stack up again, come out of the back straightaway, Morella gets caught in the pipe. Top two coming at the driver's stand, those are your leaders there. And now Little Birdie taps. Eric Anderson to the principal's office. Eric Anderson to the principal's office. Can you fix that body? Thank you, sir. Ralph Morella leaving a little bit of paint back here in the chicane, still in that top spot. He's got half a second lead with 5 seconds left to go. Leaders coming through the chicane, out on the back straightaway. Time's about to expire. Top two on the lap all by themselves. Here it is for all the marbles in the C main of 112 scale GTP stock. Oh, Little Birdie taps. Morella comes down a straightaway to collect the win. And it's all over. Final running order. Morella, Little Birdie, St. Germain, Skews, Krasinski, Crotty, Busey, and Joe Conti. Hey, Amen, guys. We'll give you a couple laps after all the announcements if you want as well. All lower mains, your plaques can be picked up in tech. Plaques can be picked up in tech.
So ignore the black writing.
Hey, Ralph.
That's all right.
A lot of happiness, Ralph. Congratulations. Great race.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Had a little action there towards the end. A little.
Yeah, I think we both wanted to give it up, but.
Funny how that works, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely.
8 minutes is a long way.
Absolutely. But it's great to be here. Fantastic place. Congratulations to everybody, and you guys did a great job.
Most important, congratulations to you. You won home a winner in the 2015 Snowbird Nationals. Ralph
much.
Morella picks up the win in the C main for 12th scale 17.5. Here is your starting lineup for the A main of 12th scale stock. From the bump up, he hails from Golden Valley, driving a Speed Merchant with a Draca body, a TSR motor, and Tekin speed control on CRC tires. Sponsored by Team Tekin and MMR, Andrew Mowry makes it to the A-Main via the bump-up yesterday morning. Starting in ninth from Lutz, Florida, driving a Red Mosquito 12-5R with a protoform body, Team Scream motor, Orion ESC and BSR Tires, sponsored by BSR Tires, Team Scream Motors, Protoform Bodies, KO Pro Pro America, Red Mosquito Raceway, Awesomatics, Rockstar Paint, Left Hander RC, TQ Wire, EA Motorsports, Jayco Tires, and also sending out a thanks to his wonderful wife, Angela. Starting in ninth position, Monty Panzica. From the eighth position, he hails from Charleston, South Carolina, driving a Speed Merchant Rev 8 with a Protoform AMR 12 body, a Trinity D4 motor, and an Orca speed control on Ulti tires. Sponsored by Speed Merchant, Trinity, RevTech, Xenon, Protoform, TQ Wire, Awesomatics USA, KO ProPro, and Ulti tires. Starting eighth is Steven Boyce. From the seventh position, he hails from Muskegon, Michigan, driving a Speed Merchant Rev 8, a Protoform Straka body, Trinity D4 motor, LRP speed control and BSR tires, sponsored by Speed Merchant, Trinity, BSR, and sending out a special thanks to Bruce Carbone, Ernie P., Andrew Knapp, Denny B., and Jim Dieter. Starting in the seventh position, Chuck Lonergan. Starting in the sixth position from Shelby Township, Michigan. He's driving an Associated 12R5.2 with a Black Art body, a Team Screen motor, and BSR tires. Sponsored by Team Associated, SMC, Team Screen, BSR, and TQ Wires. Starting in the sixth position is Joe Trandall. Fifth on the grid, from Grand Rapids, Michigan, driving a CRC with a Black Art body, a Trinity motor, Hobby Wing speed control, and CRC tires. Sponsored by CRC, Trinity RevTech, Spectrum, Xenon, SXT, Diggity Designs, and his fiance, Lauren. Starting in that fifth position is Andrew Knapp. And congratulations, Andrew. And Lauren. Starting in the fourth position from Baltimore, Maryland, driving an X-Ray X12 2015 with a Protoform body, EA Motorsports motor, an Orca speed control, and Ulti tires. Sponsored by RC America, X-Ray Hoodie, EA Motorsports, KO Propo, Protoform, Gravity RC, Avid, TQ Wire, Pro Level RC, Ulti, and 5.9s. Starting fourth, Craig Xavier. Third on the grid, from Frederick, Maryland, driving a CRC Altered Ego with a CRC Audi body, a Trinity motor, an Orca speed control, and CRC tires. Sponsored by Trinity, RevTech, CRC, Sweep, TQ Wire, Gravity RC, Middle River Hobbies, Genesis RC, Killer Concepts, and PCR Graphics. Starting third is Michael Harrell Jr. Second on the grid, from Twig, Minnesota. He's driving a CRC with a CRC body, Phantom motor, Hobby Wing speed control, and CRC tires. Sponsored by CRC, Phantom, TQ Wire, KO Propo, Genesis RC, and MIP. Starting second on that grid is John Wieda.
A five-star dinner.
And your TQ for 12-scale stock. From Farmington, Michigan. Driving a Speed Merchant with a Protoform body, a Trinity motor, an LRP speed control, and Ulti tires. Sponsored by Trinity, Speed Merchant, LRP, KO Propo, Ulti, Protoform, RC Trim, Advanced Racing. Starting on the point, your TQ for 12-scale stock of the 2015 Snowbird Nationals, Josh Searle.
Starting on the point, your TQ for 12-scale stock of the 2015 Snowbird Nationals, Josh Searle.
Craig Xavier. Josh Searle. Andrew.
All right, guys, line them up.
Speed Merchant. Monty Panzica. Andrew Mowry. John Wieda. Michael Harrell Jr. Chuck Lonergan. Joe Trandell.
All right, guys, Craig will line you guys up. It's going
Josh in the one, Wita two, Harold Jr. three, Xavier four, Knapp five, Trendell six, Lonigan seven, Boyce eight, Panzica nine, Maori 10. Gentlemen, grid is set. Turn marshals are set. Drivers, this is 112, GP Sox 17.5, A main. We'll go racing on the sound of the tone in less than five. Josh Joe's going to lead him around. Wita in the two. Harold Jr. in the three. It's the battle of the orange cars out front. Still trying to pull away a little bit. Battle going on behind him for second place between Wita, Harold Jr. and Craig Xavier. Oh! And we got cars off track. We got one stuck. Watch it coming on the straight, guys. Watch it coming on the straight. Dead car coming on the straight. Dead car coming on the straight. Dead car still there. Clear. And that was Michael Harold Jr. He is out of this one. Josh Searle in that top spot. John Wita in the two, Knapp in the three. Lonergan in the four, followed by Boyce, Xavier, Panzica, Maori, and Trendell. Joshua, your leader. The all orange car, car number one. Car number two, John Wita in second. Then it's Knapp from fifth, now into third place. Joshua Lear with 120 down, 640 left to go. We got one stock coming in the chicane, it's clear. Joshua in that top spot, 8-7 to Wita's 8-8. Later working his way through the S section into the chicane. Wita through the chicane down the straight. Cyril working on some back traffic now. Cyril with 8-7, Wita 8-8. Josh comes back with 8-7, Wita 8-7. Josh working his way through traffic. Wita through traffic. Gap showing at 7/10 of a second with 2 minutes down, 6 minutes left to go. New leader down the back straight and into the infield through the sweeper he goes. That is Josh Searle, car number one. Track. John Wita now trying to close that gap between himself and Josh Searle. Gap down to half a second now between Searle and Wita. 8-9 for Josh, 8-8 for Wita. Andrew Knapp in that third spot. Lonergan in the four. Maori in the five. Xavier in the six. Battle going on for fifth place between Maori and Xavier. Xavier up to that fifth spot. Maori in the six.
That's what happened last
year. 3:10 down. 4:50 left to go, drivers. Cyril in that top spot, Wita in the two. That's the two orange cars working way in front of the driver's stand. It's Cyril leading Wita. We got Andrew Knapp in the three. Lonergan in the four, Xavier in the five, Maori in the six, Trendell and Panzica battling out for that seventh spot. Trendell and Panzica working their way through the chicane down the backstretch. Trendell in that multicolored white fluorescent yellow, fluorescent green, excuse me, Monty in the silver fluorescent yellow. They've got Maori right in front of them. That's the battle for sixth place between Maori, Trendell, and Panzica. The white and blue of Maori, followed by Trendell and Panzica working their way through the sweeper in the infield.
Up front, we got Cyril and Guida, one and two, working their way in front of the driver's stand. In through the S, in through the chicane, and down the straightaway goes your leader, Josh Cyril, 8-9. John Guida, 8-9. Cyril not giving an inch with 4:15 down, 3:45 left. Gap shown at 6 tenths of a second between the top two. Nap in that third spot. Andrew Knapp showing 5 seconds back from the leader. Chuck Lonergan in the four, Xavier in the five, Trindell in the six, Maurer in the seven, Pansika in the eight, Stephen Boyce in the nine. The gap down to 4 tenths now. Last lap for Josh, 9 flat, Guida, 8-9. Four 50 down, 3:10 drivers, 3:10 left. Maurer and Trindell still battling out in the back of the pack for that sixth place position. Maurer currently still in sixth. Trindell right behind as they work right in front of the driver's stand. Down through the chicane and down the back stretch they go. That's the white and blue and the multicolored white fluorescent green of Trindell. And back up to the front of the pack we go with Cyril in the lead. Guida in second, gap still showing at a half a second. The 5:40 down, 2:20 left, drivers, 2:20 left. Gap still showing at 6 tenths, it hasn't moved much. Cyril and Guida staying consistent throughout this one. Cyril and Guida now catching up to that battle for that sixth spot between Maurer and Trindell. Trindell making a move on Maurer. Currently in that sixth spot, Trindell in the seven. So with 6:30 down, 1:30 left to go, we got Cyril, your leader, Guida in the two, Knapp in the three, Lonergan in the four, Xavier in the five, Maurer in the six, Trindell in the seven, Boyce in the eight, and Pansika in the nine. Josh Cyril working his way through some back traffic. 9 flat for Cyril, 9-1 for Guida, 9-1 for Knapp. Gap between first and second showing at 1.2 seconds.
One minute
to go. Seconds, drivers, 40 seconds. Maurer and Trindell still slicing and dicing. Oof. 30 seconds, drivers, 30 seconds. Josh trying to take this one from tone to tone. 112 GTD stock, 17.5 A main. Last lap for Cyril, 9.2 to Guida's 8.9. 15 seconds, drivers, 15 seconds. Gonna get two more laps.
Eight, six.
And it's time of the clock, race to the line. Josh Cyril is going to take the win in 112 GT stock, 17.5 A main. John Weed is going to finish second. Andrew Knapp finishes in third. Chuck Lonergan finishes in fourth. Craig Xavier finishes in fifth. Joe Trindell sixth. Andrew Maurer finishes in seventh. Stephen Boyce in eighth. Monty Panzeca in ninth. And Michael Harrell Jr. in tenth.
Scale stock went to the TQ holder, Josh Cyril. We were just talking. Steve made a mention to me. He said, 8 minutes, never touched a pipe. Well, it was close. Close a couple of times. But made me think. You've been around this a long time. You've won here at Snowbird Nationals many, many times. Any idea how many laps you have turned, whether it be a 12 scale on road, oval car? It's got to be a ton.
Tim McIntyre.
Oh, I don't even want to know, to be honest.
To the moon.
Yeah, I think actually the last year that we ran Snowbirds on the concrete bank track.
Yeah.
You know, so I started there and been here since, you know, last, whatever, 15 years now it's been, so.
Seems like you're a perennial winner. Every time we're here, you take home a trophy of some sort, if not many trophies. Congratulations on another win, A-Main and 12-scale stock. What a run.
Thank you, sir. Also, good run to Mr. Weta. Kept me very, very honest. Awesome.
Congratulations, John.
All right, coming up now, we have our Touring Superstock 13.5 C-Main. Still looking for a check from Brian Busey and Justin Lyons. Brian Busey and Justin Lyons. I see Busey. What about Justin Lyons? No Justin Lyons.
Brian Busey.
All right, for your Touring Superstock 13.5 C-Main. Superstock being brought to you by Xenon Racing. Your lineup is going to be as follows. Tim McIntyre is going to lead us off in the one spot. Brian Busey, 2. Zach Donathan, 3. Travis, 4. Patrick St. Germain, 5. Justin Lyons, 6. I do not have a check from Justin Lyons. Robert Cooper, 7. Steve Laliberte, 8. And Philip Vertries, 9. Once again, last call for Justin Lyons. Last call, Justin Lyons. I don't see anybody coming and yelling, telling us to wait. Sam says go. Turn marshals. Sam, who am I supposed to have over there? 1 second, guys. I'm missing a turn marshal far into the straight. Michael Harrell Jr. is down here. Drivers ready. The next sound you hear will be the start of your 13.5 C-Main in less than 5. And we're off. Smooth it out, gentlemen. Smooth it out. Your leader, Brian Busey in the 2, Zach Donathan in the 3, Virtues in the 4, Meskin in the 5, Alberti in the 6, St. Germain in the 7, Coop in the 8. It's 1 leading 2 and 3.
multicolored white, orange, and blue car working his way now through the S section, down through the chicane. Busey right behind him. Gap showing at 4 tenths back in between top two. Oh, and McIntyre gets tied up with a lap car that's going to let Busey now into that top spot. So work the way through the chicane and down the backstretch. Busey in that white, orange. Work his way in front of the driver's stand now through the S section. Down Busey 9-9 to McIntyre's 9-6. Top two working their way through the S section now through the chicane and down the stretch they go. Left to go. We got one in the penalty box. Last lap for Busey, 9-5. McIntyre, 10-4. Pick up our leader, working his way in front of the driver's stand now through the S section, down through the chicane, and down the straightaway goes Busey. McIntyre down the straightaway. Busey with about a straightaway lead now over McIntyre, showing that 2.4 seconds all on the race clock. Zach Donathan, Travis Amescu battling out for that third place right now. Oh, and something doesn't sound good in Travis's car as he pulls it over. Hopefully it's just a body. Travis got confused there. He thought it was an off-road race for a minute. 3:20 down, 1:40 left to go. We got Brian Busey on top. 9-6 for Busey. McIntyre in that second spot. Zach Donathan in the 3. Coop now in the 4. Virtues in the 5. St. Germain in the 6. Amescu in the 7. Busey once again work his way in through the infield. Down in front of the driver's stand. Through the chicane and down the street he goes. Busey 9-5, McIntyre 9-6. Zach Donathan in the 3, Coop in the 4, Virtues in the 5. Going upside down the chicane, watch those in chicane, watch those in chicane. It's clear. 25 seconds, Jarvis, 25 seconds. Seconds. That's time on the clock. Race to the line. Race to the line. Brian Busey is going to take the win in Touring Superstock 13-5 C-Main. Tim McIntyre finishes in second. Robert Cooper finishes in third. Zach Donathan in fourth. Patrick St. Germain finishes in fifth. Phil Vertrees in sixth. Travis Mescu finishes in seventh. Valiberte in 8th, Justin Lyons, DNS. A-Main, hold your cars, please. Do not come around to the straight. 13-5 A-Main, do not come around to the straight, please. Straightaway is closed.
Once again, straightaway is closed. Hold your cars.
Well, Brian Busey, big old smile. What a great way to finish up the 2015 Snowbird Nationals with a win.
Thank you.
Had a little fun out there, didn't you?
Yeah, it was good for the first couple laps, and I guess Joey got into some traffic and just ran out of gap.
How'd your week go?
It's been fun.
No drama?
No, just lack of sleep.
That's drama enough, isn't it? Lack of sleep, but loads of fun. Brian, congratulations. Great race. Your starting lineup for the Superstock 13-5 A Main. From the bump up, he'll start 10th. From Thornton, Colorado, driving an X-Ray T415 with a Protoform LTCR body, a Team EAM D4, and an Orion ESC. Sending out a special thanks to Team X-Ray, Airtronics, Avid, Protoform, TEAM. Pro Level RC and Gravity RC. Also, thanks to the guys from RC America and the crew from 5280 for all of their support. And as always, he wants to thank his wife, Jerry, and his daughter, Nicole, for the love and support they give him and letting him go racing. Starting in 10th, Art Schrimmel. News Bulletin. We just got a message, Art, from your family. And they said, remember, Valentine's Day is coming up. Got it. Yeah. Don't we all? Starting 9th, from Baltimore, Maryland, driving an Awesomatics, a Protoform body with a D4 motor and LRP speed control. Sponsored by Awesomatics, Psycho Cells Racing, LRP, Sweep, RSD, Middle River Hobbies, Trinity, FJ, Team Swiggity Swoopity or whatever. I have no clue. Might be an inside deal there. And the Spirit of Sidor, and sending out a special thanks to Mom and Dad. Starting 9th is Mike G. Is that Swiggity Swoopy? Is that what that is? Swooty. Okay, whatever. We'll move along. 8th on the grid, from Fort Collins, Colorado, driving an Awesomatics with an LTC-R, a D4 motor, and Orca speed control, sponsored by Awesomatics, Orca, Avid, Futaba, Proliform, TQ Wire, and Team EAM. Starting 8th is Kyle Klingforth. Seventh on the grid, from St. Louis, Missouri, driving an X-Ray T415 with a Protoform LTCR body, EAM D4 motor, Orca speed control, sponsored by RC America, X-Ray, Hootie, KO Propo, Gravity RC, P1 brand, Protoform, RC Scoring Pro, Team EAM, Orca, and Pro Level RC. Starting 7th is Drew Ellis. Sixth on the grid, he hails from Baltimore, Maryland, driving an X-Ray T415, body by Protoform. It's a modest speed 6 with EAM Motorsports D4 powered by an Orca VX3, tires by Jayco, that should say. Sponsors, RC America, X-Ray, Hootie, Orca, EA Motorsports, Protoform, Gravity RC, Reflex Racing, Avid, TQ Wire, Pro Level RC, Middle River Hobbies, Apex RC Pro Shop, Five Nines, and Shekels, and Sons Construction. Starting 6th is Robbie Dodge. Fifth on the grid, from Fort Myers, Florida, driving an X-Ray T415 with a Speed 6 body, and EA Motorsports D4 Motor on Orca Speed Control, sponsored by EA Motorsports, X-Ray, Hootie, RC America, Orca, Reflex Racing, Superior Hobbies, Express Hobbies, SXT, Pro Level RC, RC TV Live, Jeff's RC Studio, Easy Customs, and Gravity RC. Starting fifth is Corey Parsons. Fourth on the grid from Murfreesboro, Tennessee. He's driving an X-Ray T415 with a Protoform LTCR body, an EA Motorsports D4, and Orca Speed Control, sponsored by Team EA Motorsports, RC America, X-Ray Hootie, Orca Apex RC, Protoform, Avid, Futaba, Lee Span, Pro Level RC, Gravity RC, TQ Wire, I guess it's light speed, wasn't it? And Thunder RC. Starting fourth is Eric Anderson. Third on the grid, from Germany, driving X-Ray 15 with a Montec Mazda body, an LRP motor, and LRP speed control. Sponsored by X-Ray, LRP, Salox, WTF Fans, Montec, Hootie, Hero Seco, and Tony Sport. Starting third is Jan Rafuski. Second on the grid, from Quebec, he's driving an Associated TC 6.2 with a Protoform Dodge Dart body, a Reedy motor, and a Reedy 410 speed control. Sponsored by Associated, Reedy, Futaba, Apex RC, Protoform, BSR, CR Graphics, RC Trim, Total RC, and Pro Spec USA. Starting second is Kevin Ebert. And your TQ, all Canadian top two, from Toronto, Canada, driving a Yokomo BD715 with a Protoform Dodge Dart body, a Trinity D4 motor, and Orca speed control. Sponsored by Yokomo, Orca, Protoform, KO Propro, ProSpec, RC Trim, Gravity RC, Options RC, and Apex RC Pro Shop. On the point, your TQ for the 2015 Snowbird National Superstock Touring Car A-Main, Andrew Hardman.
All right, gentlemen, set him down. Check him in, please. Set him down. Check him in.
Kevin Ebert, Robbie Dodge, Corey Parsons, Drew Ellis, Eric Anderson, Jan Ravisky, Art Scribo, Kyle Klingforth. Andrew Hardman. Mike G.
All right, guys, I got to check from everybody. I'm going to start calling you guys down there. Line them up with Greg, please. Andrew Hardman, the one. Go ahead and head down to Greg, please. Kevin Ebert, two. Jan, three. Eric, four. Corey, five. Robbie Dodge, six. Drew Ellis, seven. Kyle, eight. Mike G, nine. And Art, 10.
last night.
Guys, Sam says we're good to go. Turn marshals, look alive. Drivers ready. Next sound you hear will be the start of your touring super stock. 13.5 A main in less than five. And we're off. Oh, tough break for Hardman to catch the pipe on the first corner. That's going to let Kevin Ebert into that top spot. Jan in the two. Ebert in the white, orange, and green working his way back in front of the driver's stand as they make their way around for their second lap. Jan Rutkowski in the two, Parsons in the three. Ebert in that top spot. Jan Rutkowski in the two, Parsons in the three. Drew Ellis in the four, Anderson in the five. They're bunching up in the back of the pack. Jan Rutkowski putting pressure on Kevin Ebert as they make their way through the chicane and down the backstretch they go. Ebert 9-3, Jan with a 9-1. Jan Rutkowski looking all over the back door of Kevin Ebert as they make their way down the stretch and in through the sweeper. Rutkowski looks on the inside, can't make it happen once again. Down the stretch they go. 9-4 for both drivers that time by. Corey Parsons sitting in that third spot. Ellis in the four. Mike G in the five. Klingforth in the six. Skirmo in the seven. Anderson in the eight. Back up to the front of the pack. We got Ebert on top. Jan Rutkowski in the two with 1:30 down. 3:30 left to go. Ebert trying to make that car 3 feet wide as they work their way down the stretch and in through the sweeper. Ebert 9-2. Jan 9-2. Parsons 9-1, Ellis 9-3, 1:45 down, 3:15 left to go, drivers. Kevin Ebert, your leader, Jan Rutkowski in the 2, Parsons in the 3, Ellis in the 4. We got Mike G right there in that 5th spot. Jan Rutkowski trying to look for an opportunity. Oh, and Jan catches the pipe. That's going to give Ebert a little bit of breathing room now. The gap shown in 9 tenths of a second between Ebert and second place Jan Rutkowski. Parsons now all over Jan Rutkowski. Parsons and then all white as they make their way down the back stretch and into the infield. Drew Ellis in that 4 spot. Mike G in the 5. Kyle Klingforth in the 6. And the back of the pack, we got Dodge and Hardman. Followed by Screamo, battling out for that 7th place position. Kevin Ebert, your leader. Jan Rutkowski in the 2, Parsons in the 3. G looking all over. Oh. Ebert on top, Rutkowski in the 2, Parsons in the 3. G in the 4, Klingforth down the 5, Hardman in the 6, Ellis in the 7. We got 3:05 down, 1:55 left to go. The gap between the top two showing at 1 second. Corey Parsons showing just 4 tenths back from Rutkowski on the clock.
Here you go.
Hardman trying to close the gap between himself and Klingforth. That gap showing at 3 tenths of a second. Kevin Ebert, your leader, 9-2 last time by. Trotheski's 9-1. That gap showing at 9 tenths of a second between the top two drivers right now. Your leader working his way in front of the driver's stand. That's the white, orange, and green car. Rutkowski in the 2, white, orange, and black. Parsons in the 3 in the all-white car. Mike G in that 4 spot. Last lap for Ebert, 9-2. Rutkowski 9-2. Parsons 9-3. That is your top three with just under 1 minute to go. 55 seconds, drivers, 55 seconds. G in the 4, Hardman in the 5, Ellis in the 6, Dodge in the 7, Klingforth in the 8, Screamo in the 9, Anderson in the 10, Hardman now jumping over that 4th spot. Hardman showing 4 seconds back from the leader right now. 35 seconds left. Jarvis, 35 seconds. Rutheski now closing that gap between himself and Ebert. Down to 3/10 now. Rutheski starting to really pour it on as they work their way through the S section. Into the chicane they go. Robbie Dodge all over the back door of Drew Ellis. Rutheski trying to close that gap between himself and Ebert with 8 seconds left. They're going to have one more lap. This will be their final lap. Rutheski looks on the inside of Ebert, can't make it happen. He looks on the inside again. Ebert and Rutheski get into it. They're going to race the line. And Jan Rutheski's going to take it on the final lap. Kevin Ebert finishes second. Corey Parsons finishes third. Mike G finishes fourth. Drew Ellis fifth. Robbie Dodge sixth. Kyle Clingford finished in seventh. R. Screamo eighth. Andrew Hardman ninth. And Eric Anderson finishes in 10th. Great race, gentlemen.
John.
Congratulations, John Rutheski, taking the Touring Superstock 13-5, A-Main. John, make your way over here. Talk to Gene. I know you can't wait. I think John's going to throw up. Just puke over
as the morning goes on, we keep ratcheting up the excitement. Jan, what a race. Last lap pass for the win in the A-Main for Superstock here at the Snowbird Nationals.
Yeah, that was awesome. I was pushing very much, make a shit mistake in the beginning, but then I want to try crash my car or take a chance to the win, and it works so nice.
You woke us up, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations. That's two wins in the 2015 Snowbird Nationals. That made the trip worthwhile, didn't it?
Two left. Thanks.
Two more to go. Okay, he's going for a lot of hardware to take back. Jan Rathison doing a great job.
All right, World GT 13.5 C Main. Bill Frayden and Sven Boehringer. Turn marshals, if I could... If none of you guys are back-to-back, if you are back-to-back, I need you to turn marshal now. If you are not back-to-back, can I get, say, three of you to turn marshal now? I need the rest of you to turn marshal the next race.
Hey, Sam.
All right, guys, here's what we're going to do. Car 1, 2, and 3. Car 1, 2, and 3. And 4, why not? 1, 2, 3, and 4, I need you guys to turn marshal this race. 5 through 10, I need you to turn marshal the next race, please. The next race has 10 drivers. This race has 2. So cars 1 through 4, I need you to turn marshal this race. 1 through 4, turn marshal this race, please. Cars 5 through 10, I need you to turn marshal the next race, please. Once again, 1 through 4, turn marshal this race. Cars 5 through 10, if you would please turn marshal the next race, I'd greatly appreciate it. 1 through 4, turn marshal this race. 5 through 10, turn marshal the next race. Bill Frayden, you're going to lead us off on the tone. Sven Boehringer, second for the World GT 13.5 C Main. If you guys could check him in, please. Bill and Sven, check him in, please.
Sven Boehringer, Bill Frayden.
All right, you guys are checked. Line them up for me, please. You guys want to start back here? It's up to you. Whatever works. I'm easy going like that. All right, gentlemen. This is World GT 13.5 C Main. You guys gonna go on the sound of the tone in less than 5. And we're off. World GT 13.5 brought to you by Speed Merchant. 5 seconds down. Bill Fraden on top, Sven in the two. Bill Fraden, that yellow and blue car, Sven in the yellow and green. Door to door going down the straightaway. Bill Fraden taps. Let's Sven get by.
This is not a big deal. This shit I can use. Look at the sponsors.
120 down, 340 left. Down 250 goes Sven on top. That's the yellow, white, and green car.
That's an expensive mistake.
Bill Fraden in second.
All right, guys. A couple notes. We got the concourse competition going to be starting here in about 45 minutes. So if you got a car you want to enter concourse, you can start bringing them out there to Victory Lane about 45 minutes. Don't forget our big race raffle will be around 1 o'clock out in the Victory Lane area. And all A main winners, top 10, and all A mains get their pictures on the podium with Miss Snowbirds. So if you made an A main, that'll be immediately following the conclusion of on road racing around noontime. So don't miss your pictures.
Left.
Can I call dibs on these if they do? How are they too big?
Sven on top, Bill Fraden in second.
One minute left.
Seconds, drivers, 20 seconds. Sven on top, Fraden in the two.
So Al and I would just take it easy on the whatever track.
And that's time. Race the line. Sven's going to take the win for the World GT 13.5 C main. Bill Fraden finishes in second. Marshals for this race are going to be racers 5 through 10. 5 through 10 from my 13.5 A main. Racers 5 through 10. So that's going to be Corey Parsons, Robbie Dodge, Drew Ellis, Kyle Klingforth, Mike G, and Art Scrimo. I need you guys out here. Just go to Sam. Sam will tell you where to go, please. Once again, Corey Parsons, Robbie Dodge, Drew Ellis, Kyle Klingforth, Mike G, and Art Scrimo.
Well, Sven, looks like you're making a habit of this in the 2015 Snowbird Nationals. Congratulations, another win.
Thank you very much. Another C main, yeah.
Well, you got more hardware to take back to Portland, right?
Yeah, thanks, Sue.
That's good, though. Yeah, good thing. Thanks for being here. I hope you had a good time this year.
Yeah, thanks.
Sven picks up a second win here in the Snowbird Nationals.
Speed Merchant.
Coming to the line are the drivers for our A main of World GT. While they're getting staged up, here is your starting lineup. Going to the A main through the bump up yesterday from Tokyo. Driving a CRC Gen 10 SE with a Sophia body, a Trinity motor, a Tekken speed control.
Kazuki Endo.
Sponsored by KimihikoYano.net,
Mario Fico.
Okay, we got to refocus here. Futaba, Paddle Racer, Trinity, Square, much more. DACA Plus, X Gear, Brain Speed Graphics, and Futaba Sanyo. Starting 10th is Kazuko Endo. Starting 9th from Portland, Oregon, driving a VBC Lightning 10 with a Protoform Sophia body, a Trinity D4 motor, a Tekken RSX speed control, sponsored by BBC Racing, Tekken, EMR Factory, Time Zone Racing, KO Propro, BSR Racing, Protoform, Max FX, and Trinity. Starting 9th is Dave Ehrlich. Eighth on the grid from Albuquerque, New Mexico, driving a VVC Lightning, a Protoform Giana body, a Trinity D4 motor, a Tekken RSX speed control with BSR tires. Sponsored by VVC Racing, Trinity, RevTech, Protoform, BSR, EMR Factory, Tekken, and Max FX. Starting in that eighth position is Max Kooning. Seventh on the grid from Charleston, South Carolina. He's driving a Speed Merchant World GT4 with a Protoform Sophia body, a Trinity D4 motor, and a Orca speed control. Sponsored by Speed Merchant, Trinity, RevTech, KO Propo, Ulti Tires, EA Motorsports, Xenon, Protoform, TQ Wires, and Awesomatics USA. Starting seventh is Steven Boyce. Sixth on the grid, and he's already looking. Yeah, we're going to have fun with this one. From Wheat Ridge, Colorado, he's driving a CRC Gen X X10 SE with a Black Art GT86 body and a Trinity D4 motor and Orca speed control. Sponsored by CRC, Dumper Speed Shop, Black Art, FBFX, 5280 Raceway, and RC America. Now, when I traveled around and did a lot of big car races, sometimes I wouldn't get a name, so I got the privilege of making up names. I had Billy Fencebender and Bobby Boltchecker and all kinds of names. Well, Mario, we knew who you were. Starting in sixth, Mario Fico. Fifth on the grid from Muskegon, Michigan, driving a Speed Merchant with a Protoform Giana body and a Trinity motor and Hobby Wing speed control. Sponsored by Speed Merchant, Trinity, and thanks going out to Bruce Carbone, Ernie P., Andrew Knapps, Denny B., and Jim Dieter, and very much thanking his wife and family. Starting fifth, Chuck Lonergan. Fourth on the grid from Rome, New York, driving a team at CRC Gen X 10SE with a black guard body, a Trinity D4 motor, and Orca speed control. Sponsored by Team CRC, Trinity, Orca, KO Propo, Dumper Speed Shop, FBFX, Blackheart, Automatics USA. Starting fourth is Brian Wynn. Third on the grid from Twig, Minnesota, driving a CRC with a CRC body, a Phantom motor with a Hobby Wing speed control. Sponsored by CRC, Phantom, TQ Wire, KO Propo, Genesis RC, MIP, and Hobby Wing. Starting third is John Wieda. Second on the grid, from Garden City, New York. He's driving a top Rebel 10 with a Protoform Giana body and a Trinity D4 motor. Speed control by LRP. His sponsors are Top, Trinity, KO Propo, TQ Wire, Protoform, Xenon, BSR, Kimbrough, and MaxFX. Starting second is Donnie Leah. Picking up more hardware at the 2015 Snowbird National. He is the TQ for World GT A-Main Action from Farmington, Michigan. Driving a Speed Merchant with a Protoform body and a Trinity D4 motor and an LRP speed control. Sponsored by Trinity, Speed Merchant, LRP, KO Propo, Ulti, Protoform, RC Trim, Advanced Racing, Xenon, and TQ Wire. We've already talked to him once today. Your TQ is Josh Searle.
Donnie Leah.
All right, gentlemen, just need a check from Josh Searle. Everybody else has checked. I'm going to call your name. Line them up. Down with Greg, please. You guys can Josh take one Searle. Last hot lap if you want. Bring him back here and park him. Sharpie, you ready? All right, in the one, Josh Searle. Two, Donnie Leah. Three, John Wieda. Four, Brian Wynn. Five, Chuck Lonergan. Six, Mario Fico. Seven, Stephen Boyce. Eight, Max Kuning. Nine, Dave Ehrlich. 10, Kazuki Endo. This is World GT 13.5 A-Main. Turn marshals. Look alive. Drivers ready. On the tone, less than five. And Josh Searle's going to lead him around. Donnie Leah right there in the two. Searle the all-orange. Donnie Leah the all-yellow. As they work their way for their second lap in through the infield. Searle 8-5, Leah 8-5. Leah looking all over the back door. Josh Searle as they work their way down the straightaway for lap number four. Five from Josh, 8-5 from Leah. Leader's gap showing at just 0.3 seconds. Lots of close battles going on all over. Good battle for fourth place between Lonergan, Kuning, and Wynn. Then we got Fico and Endo and Ehrlich battling for that seventh spot. Top two working their way down the stretch. Ooh, that was close. Leader's gap now showing at 0.4 seconds between Searle and Leah. Last lap for Cyril's 8-7, Leah 8-8. Josh Cyril in the all-orange, your leader, working his way in front of the driver's seat and through the S-section now. Into the chicane he goes with 140 down, 320 left. Gap showing at half a second now between Cyril and Leah. John Wieda in that third spot. Wieda in the all-white. Chuck Lonergan in the four. Max Kuning in the five. Ryan Wynn in the six. Kuning and Wynn separated by half a second on the race clock. Donnie Leah getting tied up in the back. Gap shown at 1.4 seconds now between Cyril and Leah. John Wieda in that third spot. Lonergan in the four. Kuning in the five. Wynn in the six. Wynn and Fico battling it out for that sixth position. Those two drivers separated by 8 tenths of a second. That is car four and six. Your leader, though, Josh Cyril, makes his way down the stretch into the infield he goes. In front of the driver's stand through the S section. And through the chicane on the back stretch goes your leader, Josh Cyril, 8-8. Leah, 8-7. Gap shown at 1.3 seconds between the top two drivers. Leah driving that all yellow. John Wieda, the all white, in third. With 3 minutes down, 2 minutes left to go. Cyril with an 8-7, Leah with an 8-6. Oh, and Leah taps. Josh now making his way through lap traffic. They let him on by. Lonergan and Kuning battling out for that fourth place spot. Still 8 tenths between those two drivers. We got 340 down, 120 left. Josh Hill trying to go tone to tone here in the World GT 13.5 A main. Leader working his way down the stretch. Into the infield, Josh goes. Front of the driver's stand through the S section. That's the all orange car. Josh Hill, your leader, 8-9 last time by. Comes back with another 8-9. Donnie Leah, 8-9 in second. Wieda in third with an 8-9. With just under a minute to go, drivers, just under a minute to go. Wieda showing 1.9 seconds back from Donnie Leah on the race clock. 45 seconds, drivers.
That was next.
Yep.
Thank you.
Way to work his way once again into the infield, front of the driver's seat, through the S section, the orange, Josh Cyril. Cyril with a 9-1, Leah with an 8-9. Lonergan and Kuning now separated by just 3 tenths of a second for that fourth place spot. That's car 5 and 8. Down the stretch, race the line. Josh Cyril makes way down the stretch to take the win in World GT 13.5. Donnie Leah finished in second, John Wieda in third, Chuck Lonergan finished in fourth, Max Kuning in fifth, Brian Wynn in sixth, Fico finished in seventh, Dave Ehrlich in eighth, Kazuki Endo in ninth, Steven Boyce finishes in tenth. Congratulations, Josh Cyril, for his win in the World GT 13.5. Amen.
Hey, Gene.
Josh Cyril, we're going to talk again. Man, you're starting to make a habit of this. TQ and win for the second time in the A mains of the Snowbird Nationals. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You got another 8 minutes to go now.
Yeah, I'd like to have a break, but it's not going to happen.
No, it's not. Got 9 other competitors. They're ready to go as well. You've been collecting some hardware. I would say this has been a very good week.
Honestly, it's been a pretty good year. I've had a lot of support from Ernie and Bruce and everybody coming back racing a lot this last year, and It's been a blast, so definitely one of my better years of racing for sure.
Sounds great. Josh, we'll let you get up there, get set. I know you got a lot on your mind. 8 minutes. And how many laps? We don't know. Thousands on thousands for Josh Searle here at the Snowbird Nationals over the years. While everybody is getting set, let's go through your starting lineup for the A-Main for 12th scale GTP Modifieds. Now, for those that have been around a while, you'll remember, we didn't used to have 10th scales. We didn't used to have shock absorbers. We were doing good to have fuel tubing on some of these cars. GTPs have been around since the beginning of electric racing. And these are the fast of the fast. Making his way to the 10th position via the bump-ups yesterday, he hails from Albuquerque, New Mexico. He's driving a VBC Lightning 12 with a Protoform AMR body, a Trinity D4 motor, and a Tekin RSX ESC with BSR tires. Sponsored by VBC Racing, Trinity, RevTech, Protoform, BSR, EMR Factory, and MaxFX. Starting 10th is Max Kooning. 9th on the grid from Portland, Oregon. Driving a VBC Lightning 12, a Protoform AMR 12 body, a Trinity D4 motor, and a Tekin RSX speed control with BSR tires. Sponsored by BBC Racing, Tekin, EMR Factory, Time Zone Racing, KO Propo, BSR Racing, Protoform, MaxFX, and Trinity. Starting 9th is Dave Ehrlich. Eighth on the grid from Grand Rapids, Michigan. Driving a CRC with a Protoform AMR body, a Trinity D4 motor, a Hobby Wing ESC, and CRC tires. Sponsored by CRC, Trinity RevTech, Spectrum, Xenon, SXT, Diggity Designs, and his dad. Starting 8th is Andrew Knapp. We move to 7th on the grid from Milwaukee. Is that Milwaukee? Looks like Milwaukee. We'll go with that. X-Ray 12, X-12 is the car with a Protoform body, a Thunder Power motor, and a Hobby Wing V31 speed control. Sponsored by RC America, X-Ray, Thunder Power, Hobby Wing, Fataba, RC Scoring Pro, Hootie, Gravity RC, RIP. RIP Podcast and Protoform along with RC and TQ82. Starting 7th, Tall Paul Lemieux. Sixth on the grid from Garden City, New York. Driving a top Rebel 12 with a Protoform AMR 12 body, a Trinity D4 motor, an LRP flow speed control with BSR tires. Sponsored by Top, Trinity, KO Propo, TQ Wire, Protoform, Xenon, BSR, Kimbrough, and MaxFX. And I've seen a lot of different colors from Plum Crazy and everything else. Donnie, I got to get a look at this car. A very unique yellow car for our sixth place qualifier, Donnie Leah. Fifth on the grid from Japan, driving a CRC XTI WC with an AMR 12 body, a Trinity D4 motor, Black Diamond speed control, and CRC tires. Sponsored by KimiHiyokoYano.net, CRC, Trinity, KO Propo, Advanced Electronics, Crest Speedway, Lee Speed, and Square. Starting 5th is Yugi Nagashima. Fourth place starter is also from Japan, driving a CRC XTI WC with an AMR body, a Trinity D4 motor, and a Vax Electronics Black Diamond speed control and a CRC rubber. Sponsored by KimiHikoYano.net, CRC, Trinity, KO Propo, Advanced Electronics, Crest Speedway, square in lead speed. Starting fourth is Hayato Ishioka. Huh? Starting third from Farmington, Michigan. Driving a Speed Merchant with a protoform body, a Trinity D4 motor, and an LRP speed control on Ulti tires. Sponsored by Trinity, Speed Merchant, LRP, KO Propo, Ulti, Protoform, RC Trim, Advanced Racing, Xenon, and TQ Wire. Third on the grid is Josh Searle. Starting from the second position from Quebec, Canada. Driving an associated 12R5.2 with a Protoform AMR body, a Reedy Mach 2 motor, and a Reedy 410 speed control on BSR tires. Sponsored by Team Associated, Reedy, Apex RC, Fataba, Protoform, BSR, CR Graphics, RC Trim, Total RC, and ProSpec USA. Starting seventh, or second rather, is Kevin Ebert. And your TQ for 12th scale GTP modified from Uppsala, Sweden. He's driving an X-Ray X12 with a Protoform AMR 12 body, an Orca TX motor with an Orca VX3 speed control, and using hot race tires. Sponsors include X-Ray, Hootie, Orca, Protoform, Sanwa, Elan Gears, TQ Wire, Avid, Gravity RC, RC Trim, Hero Sika, and P1 Brand. He also sends a special thanks out to EA Motorsports and RC America. Your TQ for 12th scale GTP modified, the 2015 Snowbird Nationals, presented by amain.com, is Alexander Hagberg.
Hi guys, I need all my turn marshals please from the last race. Need all my turn marshals from the last race. Also, I know there's a lot of confusion out there with the sheets.
Andrew,
if you look over here on this TV, this TV represents the races with the B mains at the top.
Kevin,
okay, so we ran 10 races yesterday. Those 10 were the Bs. So this TV, it says right, we're on race 22, right? That's with the Bs at the top. So we've done 12. This is race 12 of today. Technically 15. Because you have the three specs added in there. Before we run Touring Mod C main, before we go into Modified today, the Spec GT class will run their three mains. So before we run Modified, C and A, Touring Spec, excuse me, the Spec GT guys will run their three mains. Alright? So 112 GTP Super Stock 13.5, A main will run, then we will run our Spec GT cars, the three mains, C, B, and A, then we will run Touring Mod C and A. Any questions? Go ask Greg. Hope I confused you some more. All right, we got a check from everybody. Sam's going to line you all up. It's Alexander Hagberg in the 1, Ebert 2, Cyril 3, Hayato 4, Hugo 5, Leah 6, Lemieux 7, Knapp 8, Ehrlich 9, Kuning 10. Grid is set and locked. Turn marshals, look alive. Drivers ready. We go racing on the sound of the tone in less than five. off. Hagberg's going to leave into the infield. Ebert in the two. Cyril in the three. Hayato in that four spot. Oh, and Ebert catches the pipe. That's going to Cyril now up into that second spot. Ebert in the three. Hayato in the four. This is the 8 minute main. Oh, and Ebert, tough break for Ebert. Gets stuck on the pipe. Gets pushed back into that 10th spot. Alexander Hagberg out in front, showing a 1 second lead over second place of Josh Cyril. Leader down the straight in the white and green. Work his way now into the infield. That is Alexander Hagberg. Josh Cyril in that two spot. Hayato in the three. Paul Amin now up in that four spot. They were looking the five. Knapp in the six. Ebert in the seven. Hugo in the eight. Donnie Lee in the nine. Max in the 10. Ebert now trying to work his way back up through the pack. Ebert all over the back door of Andrew Knapp as they work their way down the straightaway. That's the multicolored white, orange, and green car battling with the white and blue of Andrew Knapp to make their way through the chicane down the stretch. Just in front of him, Paul Lemieux battling that with Dave Ehrlich. They are slicing and dicing their way through the chicane. Alexander Hagberg, your leader. Pick up Hagberg as he works his way through the chicane down the stretch. Josh Cyril in the two spot. Gap showing at 1.3 seconds between the top two. Cyril in the all orange. Hagberg in the white and green. Working their way through the infield once again. High off the straight, guys. High off the straight. Stay high off the straight. It's clear. Hagberg 7-7 to Cyril 7-6. Gap shown at 1.5 seconds between the top two. Hayato in the three. Ehrlich in the four. Oh, and Hagberg is caught up. Oh, and Josh gets caught up coming on the straight. Hayato now up into that two spot. Hayato in that multicolored pink car. Working his way through the chicane. Down the stretch he goes. Cyril right behind him in the all orange. That is second and third. The pink and the orange car working their way down the straightaway. Hagberg in that top spot, the white and green car, working his way through the chicane down the stretch. Watch the open stretch, clear. Leader in the infield, working his way through the S section. Oh, Ebert getting tied up. Josh here working his way through some lap traffic. Hayato right in front of him. That is the battle for second place between Hayato and Josh. They work their way down the straightaway. The all pink of Hayato, the all orange of Josh Cyril.
Wake up, Pico.
High in the sweeper, guys. High in the sweeper. High in the sweeper. Got one stuck. It's clear. Alexander Hagberg, your leader, white and green. Josh Cyril, the all orange in second. Hayato in third. Then we got Hugo in the fourth spot. Andrew Knapp in the fifth. Donnie Lee in the sixth. Ebert in the seven. Paul Lemieux in the eight. Max Koenig in the nine. Ehrlich out early. Hagberg on top, running his way into the infield once again, coming up on lap traffic. Josh Cyril in that two spot. Gap shown at 1.8 seconds with 3:30 down. 4:30 left to go in this one. Hagberg with a 7-7. Josh Cyril 7-6. Gap shown at 1.8 seconds between first and second. Hayato in that third spot. Hugo and Knapp battling for that fourth position right now. Halfway there, drivers. 4 minutes down. 4 minutes left to go. We got one upside down the straight. Watching the sweeper, guys. Stay low in the sweeper. Low in the sweeper. Low in the sweeper. Low in the sweeper. Stay low coming off the sweeper. It's clear. Hagberg, your leader. Josh Cyril in the two in the all orange. Hayato in the pink. Watch those coming in the chicane, guys. Watch those coming in the chicane. Say hi coming in the chicane. Hi coming in the chicane. It's clear. Alexander Hagberg, your leader. Last lap for Hagberg, 7-7. Josh, 7-8. Gap now showing at 1.3 seconds. Josh slowly but surely cutting away at Hagberg's lead. Hagberg working his way through the S section. Josh through the S section. Hayato through the S section. Hugo in that four spot. Hugo showing 5.6 seconds back from Hayato. Hugo in the four. Andrew in the five. Donnie Lee in the six. Ebert in the seven. Max in the eight. Lemieux and Ehrlich out early. Oh! We got 5 minutes down, 3 minutes left to go. Watch on the straight, guys. Stay low on the straight. It's clear. Gap still at 1.3 seconds. Hagberg taps. That's going to close the gap now to 6 tenths of a second between Hagberg and Josh. Leader working his way through chicane. Josh through chicane. We got 2:40 left. 7:07 for Hagberg. 7:05 for Josh. Josh is closing that gap. Zero trying to go 3 for 3 in the mains here. Leaders down the straightaway. Hagberg in the 1. Zero in the 2. That's the white and green in the all-orange car. 7:07 for Hagberg. 7:06 for Josh. Josh is definitely starting to pour it on with 2 minutes left to go. It's a drag race down the straightaway. Josh tried looking on the inside, didn't have the power to make it happen just then. Hagberg taps again. Cyril had the lift on that one. Cyril with the power. Hagberg 7-7, Cyril 7-7 with 1:40 left to go in this one. Oh, and Cyril taps. That's going to give Hagberg some breathing room now. Gap showing at 1.5 seconds with 1:25 left to go. We got Hagberg on top, Cyril in the 2, Hayato in the 3, Hugo in the 4, Knapp in the 5, Ebear in the 6, Max in the 7. Zero now showing 1.1 seconds back from Hagberg. Zero's gained 4 tenths in the past 30 seconds.
1 minute left.
And with that, we got 1 minute left to go in the 112 GTP Modified A Main. Hagberg 7-7, Josh 7-4. Hagberg trying to keep it clean for this last 40 seconds. Hagberg through the chicane, Josh through the chicane, here's Hayato. Hayato's starting to gain ground on Josh. Josh gaining ground on Hagberg here in the last 28 seconds of this one. 6 tenths now between Josh and Hagberg. 20 seconds. They're coming up on traffic. That is Knapp in front of him. Knapp lets him by. Josh is all over Hagberg once again. 5 seconds, this could be their final lap. Josh looks on the outside, looks at, makes a move on the inside. Oh! Oh! That's time. Race the line. Alexander Hagberg takes the win. Hayato finishes in second. Josh Cyril finishes in third. Josh tried to straight line the chicane and aired it out. Hugo finishes in fourth. Andrew Knapp in fifth. Kevin Bear finishes in sixth. Max in seventh.
Awesome.
Leah in eighth. Lemieux in ninth. Dave Ehrlich in tenth.
There was like five cars upside down on the straightaway.
That was awesome.
Charged the last 35.
Wow. Alexander. Good race.
How do you pull it so quickly at 2 laps and not be able to pull away from it?
Holy.
Throughout the whole race. That's ridiculous.
He was getting in the zone. Remember, Josh was having to adapt from car to car to car. So it took him a little bit to get to the flow.
Oh,
once he got in the zone, he was coming.
Oh, he shaved like 1 second or less.
Yeah, he was flying. A good way to
finish.
Yes.
Yep. Yeah. This was more of a round.
Alexander.
Still waiting on Alexander. We were busy talking about how exciting that race was. Alexander, come on over here.
Tim Moore.
What a race. You were being pressured Not once, but twice by Cyril. That was a wild finish.
Yeah, I mean, my car was really good at the start, but then it picked up a push towards the end, so I had to drive defensively.
Like,
in the end, it worked out, but it was really close. So.
It's a pretty exciting race. You got the nerves pumping, the blood pumping.
Yeah, I mean, it's a long 8 minutes, and these cars are fast, so.
I would say they're fast. That was truly a work of art out there, watching you guys cut through the traffic. Traffic did a great job of giving you guys room, let you race, do what you had to do for the most part. What a race. Congratulations on your AMA win and 12th scale modified. What a race. Alexander Hagberg gets it done here at the 2015 Snowbird Nationals.
Team OSRC. Sean Wager. Ryan Pacheco. Steve Pendergraf. Chris Leach.
All right, guys, just a heads up, before the Spec GT guys, before the Spec GT run, if all the awesome Mags drivers could meet Mike Hanulek out by the banner, out by registration, all the awesome Mags guys, before Spec GT, if you guys could meet Mike Hanulek out by the awesome Mags banner, that'd be great. This is Touring Stock 17.5, F Main. Starting in the one spot, Brian Davis. Starting in the two, Joseph Mackin. Starting in the three, Alvin Melendez. Starting in the four, Tim Moore. Starting in the five, Sean Wager. In the six, Ryan Pacheco. In the seven, Steve Pendergraf. In the eighth spot, Alan Hall. In the nine, Chris Leach. In the 10, William Jossens. And in the 11th spot, Matthew Burgett. Forget, line it up in the back, please. Drivers ready.
I don't think we're going to have to, but we'll see.
Next sound you hear will be the start of your Touring Stock 17.5 F Main in less than five. And we're off.
Bye, Duck.
Brian Davis going to lead him around.
Yeah, we're good.
Melendez in the two. McMackin in the three. Brian Davis in that white and green car in the top spot.
Back here when they got into it.
Yeah, those two got in the air.
Oh, no. Hayato was just on his lip. Oh, yeah. Because they both,
Hayato finished with an 8 or like 03, but it was on his lid and he finished.
As long as 120 down, 340 left. We got Davis in the lead. This is Touring Stock F Main. Pick up our leader, Brian Davis, working his way once again back in through the infield. Watch those on the straight, guys. Low on the straight, low on the straight. High on the straight, high on the straight. It's clear. Davis in that top spot. Allen Hall in second. Wow, that hurt. Davis on top. Allen Hall in second. Hall showing half a second back. Brian Davis in that white and green car. Allen Hall in second in that copper color white. Oh my God. .245 down, .215 left to go. It's Davis on top, Allen Hall in second, Tim Moore in third. Hall now showing 1 second back from Davis. Hall puts himself in the penalty box, gets himself back out. That's one way to do it. Down the straight in the white and green. Tim Moore now up in that second spot. Tim Moore and Allen Hall battling out for that second position. Moore with a 10-8. Allen Hall with a 10-6. Moore and Hall down the straightaway. Moore in that light blue, kind of green car. Car number 4. Allen Hall right behind him in that copper white car. That is the battle right now for second place. Working their way through the S section. Down in through the chicane they go. That's a battle for second place right now between Tim Moore and Allen Hall. Al Melendez right there. It's a battle heating up for second place right now. Allen Hall. And Al Melendez gets by Hall. Melendez now up into that third spot. Setting his sights now on Tim Moore. Gets by Tim Moore. Al Melendez, a man on a mission. Melendez now up into that second spot. Setting his sight on Brian Davis. With 4:30 down, 30 seconds to go. Oh, and Albin decides to take an excursion under the skirt. Melendez now down to that third spot. Seconds ago, we got Brian Davis on top, Tim Moore in second, Melendez in third, Allen Hall in fourth, Pacheco in fifth, McMacken in sixth, Sean Wager in seventh, Steve Pendergraf in eighth, Chris Leach in ninth. Get out early. Next time on the clock, everybody keep going, race the line. Brian Davis going to take the win. Tim Moore in second. Al Melendez in third. Allen Hall in fourth. McMacken in fifth. Pacheco in sixth. Sean Wager in seventh. C. Pendergraf in eighth. Chris Leach in ninth. Next, E-Main, set him down, check him in, guys. Set him down, check him in. We'll get you guys lined up.
Eric Epp, Philip Retrees, Steve Laliberte, Ryan Kuhn, Gilbert Santos, Blake Ryan, Kyle Rumpel, Daryl Bingner,
Still waiting to hear from Davis.
Jameis and Richard.
Survives what I had to look back at there because it was starting to sound like it was 8 hours ago in the figure eight. There was a lot of action going on out there.
Yeah, there was.
It's amazing what you can do with your eyes closed, right?
Yeah. It's probably the funnest I've had all week was the figure eight.
Figure eight was fun too. Yes, it was. Great win. Congratulations. You're going to go home with some hardware here from the Snowbird Nationals, and I know that makes it all worthwhile, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
How was your week?
Very tiresome, but fun.
Okay, no drama.
No.
You're one of the few. Everybody's got drama this week. Lots of fun, Brian. Again, congratulations. Glad you're here. And we'll see you next year?
Yes.
Sounds good. Brian Davis gets it done here in action for the Snowbird Nationals with a main win. Tim?
Hi, guys. Tony Stock, E-Main. Everybody's checked in. Daryl Binger's going to lead us off on the tone. Blake Ryan sitting in that second spot. Jameson Riker, third. Steve Laliberte, fourth. Eric Epp, fifth. Phil Vertry, sixth. Ryan Kuhn, seventh. Chris Crowder, eighth. Kyle Rumpel, nine. Gilbert Santos, 10. He's a tampon. All right, turn marshals are set. Drivers ready. Gentlemen, the next sound you hear will be the start of your Touring Stock 17.5 E-Main in less than five. Ooh, smooth it out, gentlemen, smooth it out. Is going to lead us off for our first lap. One on the straight, guys. Other side, other side, other side. Thank you. Daryl Binger in the one. Binger with a lot of breathing room. 3.3 seconds. Jameson Riker in the two. Vertries in the three. Rumpel in the four. Crowder in the five. Santos in the six. Blake Ryan in the seven. Ryan Kuhn in the eight. CL Alberti in the nine. Concourse, concourse. If anybody has a body for concourse, please bring them out. By the podium, out by registration. Concourse, if you have a body for the concourse, please bring it out. Spec GT, remember you guys will be up before mod. Down 3:45 left to go. We got Daryl Binger on top. Jameson Riker in the two. Kyle Rumpel in the three. Vertries in the four. Battle right now for the third place between Kyle Rumpel and Phil Vertries. They're right there behind second place. Kyle Rumpel now up in that second place. Vertries in the three. Crowder up into that four spot. Ryan Kuhn in the five, Laliberte in the six, Jameson Riker in the seven, Santos in the eight, Blake Ryan in the nine. Daryl Binger, your leader, trying to go tone to tone. With 2 minutes down, 3 minutes left to go. Watch on the straight, guys. Go low on the straight. Low on the straight. Clear. Halfway. away there, drivers. 2:30 down, 2:30 left to go. Gap between first and second showing at 8.4 seconds right now. Way in front of the driver's stand now through the S section. That's car number one. That's the white, black, orange stripe at the bottom. Leader down the straightaway. Bigner with a 10-3. Rumpel in the 2 with a 10-4. Virtues in the 3 with a 10-2. We got 3:20 down, 1:40 left in this touring stock, 17.5, E-Main. Touring stock being brought to you here at the 2015 Snowbird Nationals by EA Motorsports. Oh, we got one off in the cheap seats. Watch it in the sweeper, guys. Stay tight through the sweeper, tight through the sweeper, tight through the sweeper. Clear. It's there again. And you're clear. Come up on our 1 minute warning.
1 minute left.
Darrell Bigner, your leader, showing a 7.7 second lead over second place. Watch on the straightaway, guys. Go high on the straightaway. High coming on the straight. High coming on the straight. It's clear. Watch cells coming in through the chicane. Clear. Seconds left. Bigner on top. Kyle Rumpel in the second. Virtues in the 3. It's 1 leading 9 and 6. Seconds. And that's time. Race to the line, race to the line. Darrell Bigner's going to take that one. Kyle Rumpel finishes in second. Phil Vertrees finishes in third. Jameson Reichert in fourth. Steve Valverde in fifth. Blake Ryan in sixth. Gilbert Santos finishes in seventh. Ryan Kuhn in eighth. Chris Crowder in ninth. Eric Epp, DNS. Race 25, touring stock, D-Main, you are up.
Michael Bruce, Al Sodano, Joey Krasinski, Justin Lyons, Robert Cooper, Ralph Morella, Zach Donovan, Joshua Knight, Tony Rumpel, Jared Parsons.
Darrell Bigner, great race. E-Main winner here in the Snowbird Nationals. Going to go home with some hardware.
Oh, well, hardware's good. It was just more fun just visiting with all my old friends.
That is a lot of what this race is about, and a lot of different races. You know, I've been all over the country doing a lot of different types of racing, and it's a social event that happens to have a race attached to it.
Exactly. You're exactly right. I think that's kind of unanimous around here, but I haven't done one of these deals in 20-some years, and it's kind of fun to see some of the old people.
probably very surprising to see the changes in technology, too. I think you're probably from the era that I am, that when I got started, we didn't have shocks. We didn't have a lot of what we had.
Baby.
It was a stick car.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
We've come a long way. Daryl, congratulations. Great win.
All right, touring stock D main. Slide him up. Michael Bruce starting in that top spot. Joey Krasinski in the two. Al Sedano, three. Jarrett Parsons, four. Zach Donathan, five. Justin Lyons, six. Ralph Morella, seven. Joshua Knight, eight. Robert Cooper, nine. And Tony Rumpel in the 10. Marshall's in the middle. Eric, can you guys move back off the straight for the start? Thank you. All right, turn marshals are set. Grid is set and locked. Jarvis is touring stock 17.5 D main. We go racing at the sound of the tone in less than five.
Good.
Michael Bruce going to lead him around to the loop for the first lap. Joey Krasinski in the two. Al Sedano in the three. Jared Parsons in the four. Your leader, Michael Bruce, that multicolored white, yellow, orange, green car. Joey Krasinski in that second spot. That's that pink, white, and black car. Jarrett Parsons now up into that third spot. That's that orange car.
I'm ready. Seriously, we got so far.
Tough break for Krasinski. That drops him way back in the pack. Jarrett Parsons now up into the two. Joshua Knight now in the three. Al Sedano now in the three. Tony Rumpel in the four. Krasinski in the five. Cooper in the six. Joshua Knight in the seven. Michael Bruce, your leader. Bruce working his way down through the chicane and down the back straight. Jarrett Parsons in the two. 9.7 for Bruce. 9.5 for Parsons. Gap between the top two showing at 9/10 of a second. That's Bruce and Parsons. Bruce this time by 9.9. Parsons 9.5. Parsons setting his sights on Bruce. Top two working their way now in through the chicane and down the straightaway. Parsons closing that gap on Bruce with a quickness. Through the S section they go now down through the chicane. 9.6 for Bruce, 9.8 for Parsons. We got 1:45 down, 3:15 left to go. Michael Bruce starting to pick up the pace now. 9.8 for Bruce, 9.9 for Parsons. Parsons starting to tighten it back up. Getting right back up there on Bruce. Bruce and Parsons making their way once again in front of the driver's stand through the S section. Watch those in chicane, guys. Oh! And Bruce tries to avoid an accident on the straightaway. That lets Parsons get on by. Jarrett Parsons, your new leader. Parsons through the chicane. Bruce through the chicane. Down the straightaway they go. Parsons 9.6 to Bruce's 9.9. Parsons catches the corner. Bruce all over the back door. Parsons now. Top two working their way through the chicane and down the straightaway in this touring stock 17.5 D main. Al Sedano on that third spot. Josh Knight in the four. Tony Rumpel in the five. Coop in the six. Donovan in the seven. Krasinski in the eight. Lyons in the nine. Top two working their way down the straightaway. Right now the gap showing at 1 second. Leader working his way through the S section now, in through the chicane and down the straightaway he goes. That is Jarrett Parsons. Gap showing at 8/10 now. Michael Bruce gaining a little bit of time. Jared Parsons, 10 flat. Michael Bruce, 9-7. Bruce now once again gaining time back on Parsons. Gap shown at 6/10 of a second now between Parsons and Bruce. Parsons in the all orange, Bruce in the multicolored white, orange, yellow, and green. Parsons coming up on some back traffic. Leader is in all orange, be advised, leader is in all orange, working his way through the pack. Second place in the white, yellow, and green. Watch it on the straight, guys. All orange, oh, Jared Parsons get tied up with some back traffic. That's what Michael Bruce now back in that top spot. Top two once again working their way through the chicane. Coming up on one to go.
1 minute left.
It's Bruce on top, 9-9. Parsons, 9-7. Parsons once again setting his sights on Michael Bruce as they work their way down the backstretch. And into the infield they go. Parsons catches the corner. Seconds to go. Parsons trying to tighten it up, catch Michael Bruce. 30 seconds, Jarvis, 30 seconds. Seconds. Jared Parsons all over Michael Bruce once again. 12 seconds. They're going to get at least one more lap. Parsons looks on the inside of Bruce once again. He is all over Bruce. 3 seconds, two, one. They're going to get one more lap. Race to the line. Parsons makes the pass once again. Race to the line. Parsons is going to take it. Michael Bruce finishes in second. Robert Cooper in third. Joshua Knight in fourth. Krasinski in fifth. Rumpel in sixth. Zach Donovan in seventh. Justin Lyons in 8th, Al Sedano in 9th, Ralph Morello finishes in 10th.
I mean, I got a Woody, but that's different.
No. Well, I can verify.
Come on, Derek. Come on, Derek.
Man, I got goosebumps on that.
And to think that that was the touring stock D-Main. Great race by Jared Parsons and Michael Bruce. Battled out throughout the race for a full 5-minute run.
All right, guys, a couple notes. Concours is starting up right now. If you got a car you'd like to have on display down there, please bring your Concours cars. The girls are here, and we got two categories, best looking and most authentic. So head on down and bring your cars to Victory Lane.
Our D-Main winner in touring stock. You know, it wasn't but just a few years ago, I remember you racing in the parking lot over at Superior with a TC3 getting started with VTA, and now you're a D-Main winner here at the Snowbird Nationals. Jared Parsons, congratulations. You're coming on strong, my friend.
Madler.
Yep. Yep. Get one of those Jake Elder interviews. We broke. Is that what we got?
Maybe.
Maybe. Well, Jared, congratulations. I know you don't want to talk, but did a great job out there. Outstanding pass. You and Michael Bruce put on a heck of a show. Michael, a little bit of kudos to you as well. You did a great job. Both of you had to work traffic. You got hung up with traffic a couple of times.
Yep.
Did y'all talk to each other up there on the stand?
No.
Do you know how to say anything else?
Andrew Mallory.
Okay. We'll work on that later. Jared Parsons, great job.
Touring stock guys, I still need a check from Bill Sidor, aka Helicopter. Jerry Birchfield, Patrick St. Germain, Anthony Saunders, and Brian Card.
All right, guys, one more time. Concours is happening right now. If you got a car you'd like to put in Concours, please Jerry head on down there. Victory Lane.
Bill Sitter.
All right, guys, grid is set and locked. So this is Touring Stock 17.5 C Main. Starting off that top spot, we got Henrik Heisch. Starting second, Bill Sider. Third, Sebastian Mador. Fourth, Stephen Boyce. Fifth, Isaac Morgan. Sixth, Jerry Birchfield. Seventh, Andrew Mowry. Eighth, Patrick St. Germain. Ninth, Anthony Saunders. And 10th, Brian Card. Turn marshals are live. Drivers. Next time you hear will be the start of your Touring Stock 17.5 C Main in less than 5. Oh, we got one off the cheap seats already. It's a drag race down the straightaway. Henrik's going to lead them around for their first lap. Sebastian Mador in second. Henrik in that white and green car. Oh, and Sebastian gets stuck on a pipe. Oh, and Sebastian does the right thing and waits for him, but gets his clock cleaned in the process.
He had a dirty clock.
Bill Sider now up in the second. Stephen Boyce in third. Sider in that multicolored white, orange, and blue car. Stephen Boyce now in the black car into second. Brian Card in fourth. Henrik in that top spot. Boyce in the two. Sider in the three. Card in the four. Second, third, and fourth working their way through the sweeper into the infield. Henrik showing a 1.9 second lead over Boyce in second. Boyce getting pressure from Bill Sider. Second and third right there in front of the driver's stand. That's the all black and the white, orange, and blue car. That is second and third of Stephen Boyce and Bill Sider. Your leader, the white and green of Henrik Heisch, working his way into the infield in front of the driver's stand through the S section. Henrik 9.5 last time by, to Boyce is 9.9. Boyce drops a 9.7 to Bill Sider's 9.9. Brian Card right there. It's a good battle going on for second place. Stephen Boyce currently in that second spot, followed by Bill Sider in third, Brian Card in fourth. We got 150 down, 310 left to go. Sider trying to make a move on Stephen Boyce. As they work their way through the chicane and down the backstretch. Both cars pretty evenly matched. Henrik Heisch, your leader, through the chicane and down the backstretch. Sider and Boyce still duking it out for that second position. Boyce catches a pipe, doesn't lose any ground though. Halfway there, drivers, 230 down, 230 left to go in this Touring Stock 17.5 C Main, brought to you by EA Motorsports. Bill Sider tries to make a move coming through the sweeper. Looks on the inside, looks on the outside. Tries to overpower. Oh, and Boyce catches the pipe through the chicane. That's going to put Bill Sider now up in that second position. Boyce in third. Brian Card. Isaac Morgan down in that fourth spot. Brian Card in fifth. Mowry in sixth. Birchfield in seventh. Sebastian Mador in eighth. St. Germain in ninth. Anthony Saunders in tenth. In that top spot, that's the white and green car working its way through the chicane and down the backstretch. Gap between Henrik and Bill showing at 2.5 seconds. Henrik with a 9.5, Bill with a 10.1. Stephen Boyce in that fourth spot, Isaac Morgan in the fifth spot. The gap between Boyce and Morgan showing at 2.6 seconds right now. Some help in the middle, please. Watch yourselves through the S section, guys. Watch yourselves through the S section. It's clear. 3:50 down, 1:10 to go. 1:10 to go. Henrik Heisch, your leader. Bill Sider in second. Gap between first and second showing 3.3 seconds. Working on 1 minute to go.
1 minute left.
Henrik Mike on top, Bill in the 2, Stephen Boyce in the 3, Isaac Morgan in the 4, Mowry in the 5, Birchfield in the 6, Sebastian Mendora in the 7, Card in the 8, St. Germain in the 9. Hedrick with a 9-5 to Bill Siders, 9-9. Boyce and Sider are going to go at it once again for that second position. Sider in the multicolored white, orange, and blue car. Boyce in the all black, working their way off the sweeper into the infield. Boyce looks on the inside, ends up stuffing it. They're right back at it through the chicane and down the straightaway. With 10 seconds left to go, they're going to get one more lap to duke it out.
Body.
It's time on the clock. Race to the line, gentlemen. Race to the line. Henrik Heisch going to take the win. Bill Sider finishes in second. Stephen Boyce in third. Isaac Morgan finishes in fifth. Sebastian Mendora in sixth. Jerry Birchville finishes in seventh. Brian Card in eighth. Patrick St. Germain finishes in ninth. Anthony Saunders finishes in tenth. Touring Stock 17-5, A Main coming up next.
Henrik.
Henrik Heisch picks up the win in the C Main for Touring Stock. Henrik, congratulations.
Thank you.
A lot of action out there here in this main action. Any close calls for you?
I think it was easy, but my speed was good and no problems.
First time to the Snowbirds?
Yes.
I didn't think I remembered your name from years past. What are your impressions?
I was really, really funny. Was figure 8 race yesterday and something. Was nice.
We're kind of crazy, aren't we?
Yes.
To say the least. Henrik, congratulations. Glad to have you here and hope to see you soon.
Robbie Duff.
Maybe.
Sounds good. Look forward to seeing you back here at the Snowbird Nationals presented by amain.com.
You're welcome.
While our cars are getting gridded up, let's take a look at your starting lineup for the A Main for Stock Sedan 17-5. Making his way into the A Main via the bump up from yesterday. Starting 10th from Thornton, Colorado, driving an X-Ray T415 with a Protoform LTCR body, Team EA Motorsports D4, and an Orion Speed Control. Sending out thanks to Team X-Ray, Airtronics, Avid, Protoform, Team EA Motorsports, Pro Level RC, and Gravity RC. And also thanking the guys from RC America and the crew from 5280 for all of their support. And he's always thankful that his wife and daughter, Jerry and Nicole, support him going racing. Ladies and gentlemen, starting in the 10th position, Art Schrimmo. Well, we call this the Snowbird Nationals, but this driver has taken it to the next level. He now hails from Lutz, Florida, driving an Awesomatics Evo with a Protoform Mazda 6 body, Team Scream motor, an Orion speed control, and, of course, the spec tire. Sponsored by Awesomatics, Team Scream motors, Protoform bodies, KO Propo America, Rockstar Paint, EA Motorsports, BSR Tires, Jayco Tires, TQ Wire, Left Hander RC, Red Mosquito Raceway, and thanks to Mike Hedelec and his wife. Ladies and gentlemen, he's no longer a snowbird. He's a resident here in Florida, Monty Panzica. And next, we'll take him out to see the alligators. Starting 8th, from Orlando, Florida, driving an Awesomatics Evo 2 with a Protoform Speed 6 body, a Trinity D4 motor, a Orca speed control, and a RevTech battery.
sponsored by Trinity, RevTech, Awesomatics, Wild Turbo Fan, Genesis RC Products, The Spirit of Sidor, and SuperiorHobbies.com. Starting eighth is Mark Burt. Seventh on the grid from Baltimore, Maryland. Driving an X-Gray T415 with a Protoform Mazda Speed 6 body, an EM Motorsports D4, and an Orca Speed Control. Sponsored by RC America, X-Ray, Hootie, Orca, EA Motorsports, Protoform, Gravity RC, Reflex Racing, Avid, TQ Wire, Pro Level RC, Middle River Hobbies, Apex RC Pro Shop, Five Nines, and Shackles and Sons Construction. Starting seventh is Robbie Dodge. Sixth on the grid from Frederick, Maryland. Driving a Yokomo BD7 with a Protoform Speed 6 body, a Trinity Certified D4, and an Orca Speed Control. Sponsored by Trinity, RevTech, Sleep, TQ Wire, Gravity RC, Middle River Hobbies, Genesis RC, Killer Concepts, and PCR Graphics. Starting sixth is Michael Harold Jr. Fifth on the grid from Baltimore, Maryland. Driving an X-Ray T415 with a Protoform Speed 6 body, EA Motorsports D4, and an Orca Speed Control. Sponsored by RC America, X-Ray Hootie, EA Motorsports, KO Propo, Protoform, Gravity RC, Avid, TQ Wire, Pro Level RC, Ulti, and 5.9. Starting fifth is Craig Xavier. Fourth on the grid from Murfreesboro, Tennessee. He's driving an X-Ray T415 with a Protoform LTC body, EA Motorsports D4 with the Orca Speed Control. Sponsored by RC America, X-Ray Hootie, Team EA Motorsports, Orca, Apex RC, Avid, Futaba, Pro Level RC, Lee Speed, Protoform, Gravity RC, TQ Wire, and Thunder RC. Starting fourth is Eric Anderson. Third on the grid from Fort Myers, Florida. Driving an X-Ray T415 with a Speed 6 body, an EA Motorsports T4, and an Orca Speed Control. Sponsored by EA Motorsports, X-Ray, Hootie, RC America, Orca, Reflex Racing, Superior Hobbies, Express Hobbies, SXT, Pro Level RC, RCTV Live, Jeff RC Studio, Easy Customs, and Gravity RC. Starting third is Corey Parsons. Starting second from Baltimore, Maryland, driving an Awesomatics with a Protoform body and a D4 motor, with an LRP Speed Control. Sponsored by Awesomatics, CycloCells Racing, LRP, Sweep, RSD, Middle River Hobbies, Trinity, FJ, Team Swiggity Swoopy, or Swooty? Swiggity Swooty, okay. They that fast. The Spirit of Sidor, and special thanks to Mom and Dad. Starting second is Mike G. TQ for 17.5 touring car from Germany. Driving an X-Ray 15 with a Montec body, LRP motor, and LRP flow speed control. Sponsored by X-Ray, LRP, Savox, WTF Fans, Montec, Hootie, Hero Seco, and Tony Sport. Your TQ for the 2015 Snowbird Nationals presented by Amain.com in 17.5 touring car is Jan Rafuski. That is your starting grid.
Oh, this is right. This is, hey, you'll do this. Art Scrimo. Michael Herald.
Hi, guys. Get a few hot laps in.
Monty Panzica. Mike G.
All right, everybody's checked.
Parsons.
Guys, bring him back here and park him. I'm going to call you up to Greg. Bring him back here and park him, please. I'll call you up to Greg. Watch you guys. Straightaways closed. Straightaways closed. Bring him back here and park him, please. All right. Starting in the top spot, Jan. Head up to Greg, please. Starting in the one, Jan. Head up to Greg, please. Starting in the two, Mike G. Three, Corey Parsons. Four, Eric Anderson. Five, Craig Xavier. Six, Michael Harrow Jr. Seven, Robbie Dodge. Eight, Mark Burt. Nine, Monty Panzica. And 10, our bump up, Art Scrimo. Gentlemen, grid is locked. Turn marshals are set. Driver's ready. Next down your heel will be the start of your touring stock 17.5 A Main in less than 5. And we're off. Jan Rathesi is going to lead him into the infield. Mike G in that second spot. Oh, Corey Parsons taps out. Let's go put Eric Anderson up into that third spot.
Body guard.
Jan Rathesi in that top spot. Mike G in the two. Eric Anderson in the three. Eric Anderson now up in the second spot.
Come on, G.
Mike G taps coming onto the straight. That's going with EA in that second spot now. We got Robbie Dodge in the four. Harold Jr. in the five. Mark Burt in the six. Art Scrimmel on the seven. Monty Panzica in the eight. Corey Parsons in the nine. Craig Xavier in the 10. With 40 seconds down, 4:20 left to go. We got Jan Rathesi leading him into the infield. Jan, that multicolored white, orange, and black car. EA in the pink, blue, and silver.
Jan, fast lap.
That is one and two. Mike G sitting in that third spot. Robbie Dodge in the four. Robbie Dodge getting pressure from Michael Harrell Jr. as they work their way through the sweeper into the infield. That's the white and orange, and the white, orange, and silver car. Oh, and Harrell Jr. taps. That's going to put Mark Burt now up into that fifth spot. Michael Jr. now down into sixth. And we got a battle for seventh place between Art, Corey, Monty, and Craig. Down, 3:30 left. Jan Rathesi showing a 1.6 second lead over Eric Anderson in that second spot. Mike G showing 3/10 back from EA on the clock. Second and third working their way through the chicane. That's Eric Anderson and Mike G. Down the straightaway they go. Mark Burt and Michael Hill Jr. battling out for that fifth spot as they work their way in through in front of the driver's stand. That's the yellow and orange and the multicolored white, red, and black car. Harold Jr. gets by Mark Burt. Harold Jr. now up in that fifth spot. But our leader, Jan Rathesi, working his way in front of the driver's stand now. Down through the chicane and down the straightaway he goes. Mike G now putting pressure on Eric Anderson as they make the way down the straightaway. That is for second place. Eric Anderson 9-3, Mike G 9-3. Our leader, Jan Rathesi, working his way now once again in front of the driver's stand. In through the S section, through the chicane and down the straightaway goes Jan. Eric Anderson down the straightaway. Mike G down the straightaway. We got 2:45 down, 2:15 left to go in touring stock 17.5 A Main here at 2015 Snowbird Nationals, presented by amain.com. Good battle going on in the back of the pack for fifth place between Harold Jr., Mark Burt, and Art Scrimo. Those three drivers working their way through the chicane and down the straightaway. It's Harold Jr. leading Burt and Scrimo. Craig Xavier now getting into that mix. Eric Eric Anderson now gaining ground on Jan Rothesky with 1:30 left. The gap was at 1.9 seconds. It's down to 1.2 seconds now. Mike G taps out. That's going to put Robbie Dodge now on Mike G's bumper. That is for third position. Gap down to 1.1 seconds now. Eric Anderson starting to close that gap on Jan Rothesky. Jan in front of the driver's stand. Eric in front of the driver's stand. Jan in that white, orange, and black car. Eric in the pink, blue, and silver as they work their way once again into the infield off the sweeper. In front of the driver's stand they go. They've got Parsons in front of them. Jan gets by. Eric gets by. Gap down to just a half a second now between Eric Anderson and Jan Rothesky. It's down to 4/10 now between Jan and Rothesky. We got 40 seconds left. Last lap for Jan, 9.5. Eric Anderson, 9.5. Mike G in that first spot. Robbie Dodge in the four. Eric Anderson now all over Jan Rothesky. Jan catching up to some lap traffic. 15 seconds left, drivers. 15 seconds left. Eric Anderson starting to really pour it on now. We got 10 seconds left. They're going to get one more lap. Jan Rothesky trying to hold off a hard charge. And Eric Anderson, 3, 2, 1. That's time. Race the line. And Jan Rothesky's going to take the win. Eric Anderson finishes in second. G trying to hold off Robbie Dodge. And Mike G finishes third. Robbie Dodge in fourth. Craig Xavier fifth. Mark Burr finishes sixth. Corey Parsons seventh. Art Scrimmo eighth. Monty Panzeca ninth. And Michael Harrell Jr. finishes in 10th. Congratulations, Jan Rothesky, taking home the win in Touring Stock 17-5 A-Main. Presented by EA Motorsports. Coming up next, 112 GTP Superstock 13-5 A-Main.
Well, Jan Rothesky, you know, there are habits. But this is a pretty good habit to have, coming over and talking to me after a win here at the Snowbird Nationals, isn't it?
Yeah, I can't be improved it more. So, I'm very speechless now. It all works very good, so I'm happy.
I can see that. I can see that. Heck of a job. And you were being pressured. Eric Anderson was really closing in there. He had a little problem right there towards the end. Gave you a little bit of breathing room. But I'm not so sure you even got a chance to take a breath.
No, it was not a breath. I very do my best. I try to drive a safe line. But I think 1 minute more and I Ryan just second.
Well, Jan, fantastic job here this year. We look forward to seeing you back many years to come.
I try my best. Thank you.
Joe Trandell. John Weeda. Sal Amato.
GTP 12 scale, these are the 13.5 powered machines coming up next for their A-Main. And here is the lineup for the A-Main for GTP 12 scale. Starting 10th, transferring in via the bump up main yesterday from Virginia Beach, Virginia. Driving a top with a Wallace F 12SS conversion, Protoform AMR 12 body, a Trinity D4 motor, and a Hobby Wing speed control on Ulti tires. Sponsored by Wallace Motorsports, Ricard Racing, Gravity RC, and Ulti tires along with Trinity. Starting 10th is Mike McDaniels. Starting 9th from Rome, New York. Driving a team CRC XDIWC with a black hard body, a Trinity D4 motor, and an Orca speed control on CRC tires. Sponsored by Team CRC, Trinity, Orca, KO Propo, Dumper Speed Shop, FBFX, Black Art, and Awesomatics USA. Qualifying 9th is Brian Wynn.
Starting eighth from Fresh Meadows, New York, driving a Top Rebel with a Protoform AMR body, a Trinity D4 motor, and Orca speed control, rolling on BSR tires. Sponsored by Trinity, BSR, TQ Wire, Boca Bearings, EA Motorsports, and KO Propo. Starting eighth is Sal Amato. Starting seventh from Shelby Township, Michigan, driving an Associated 12R 5.2 with a Protoform body, a Team Screen motor, rolling on BSR tires. Sponsored by Team Associated, SMC, Team Screen, BSR, and TQ Wire. Starting seventh is Joe Trandell. Starting sixth from Albuquerque, New Mexico, driving a VDC Lightning 12 with a Protoform AMR body and a Trinity D4 motor. He's also using a Tekin ESC and rolling on BSR tires. Sponsored by VBC Racing, Trinity, RevTech, Protoform, BSR, EMR Factory, Tekin, and Max FX. Starting sixth is Mac Kooning. Starting fifth from Lutz, Florida, driving a red Mosquito RR5, using a Protoform body, a Team Screen motor, and an Orion speed control on BSR tires. Sponsored by BSR Tires, Team Screen motor, Protoform bodies, KO Propo America, Red Mosquito Raceway, Awesomatics USA, Rockstar Paint, Left-Hander RC, TQ Wire, EA Motorsports, Jayco Tires, and sending out a special thanks to his wife, Angela. Starting fifth is Monty Panzica. Starting fourth from Twigg, Minnesota, he's driving a CRC with a CRC Lola body, Phantom motor, and Hobby Wing speed control with CRC tires. Sponsored by CRC, Phantom, TQ Wire, KO Propo, Genesis RC, MIP, and Hobby Wing. Starting fourth is John Weida. Third on the grid, driving a Top Rebel with a Protoform AMR 12 with a Trinity D4 motor and Hobby Wing speed control using BSR tires. Sponsored by Top USA, SuperiorHobbies.com, BSR, TQ Wire, Trinity, The Raceway in Beaver, Pennsylvania, and Beachline Raceway. Starting third is Ray DeRoach. Starting second from Garden City, New York, he's driving a Top Rebel 12 with a Protoform AMR 12 body and a Trinity D4 certified motor using an LRP flow speed control and rolling on BSR tires. Sponsored by Top, Trinity, KO Propo, TQ Wire, Protoform, Xenon, BSR, Kimbro, and Max FX. He bought a lot of this really bright yellow paint. Starting second is Donnie Leah. And it is bright, Donnie. Very bright. TQ. What does this make? Three? Three times here in the 2015 Snowbird Nationals, this driver has TQ'd his class. From Farmington, Michigan, driving a Speed Merchant with a Protoform body and a Trinity D4 motor using an LRP speed control on Ulti tires. Sponsored by Trinity, Speed Merchant, Protoform, LRP, KO Propo, LRP, RC Trim, Advanced Racing, Xenon, and TQ Wire. We've talked to him twice before. Here he rolls from the TQ spot again. Ladies and gentlemen, your TQ for 12 scale 13.5 is Josh Searle.